Okay, so in this video, we're going to take a look at a couple of questions involving timetables. So for this first question, we have that a train leaves London St Pancras at 7:58. How long in hours and minutes does it take to reach Paris? So the first thing we want to do here is find the 7:58 train that leaves London St Pancras. So if we look at the top row, we can see the trains that are leaving London St Pancras. We've got one at 5:43, the next one at 6:21, the next one after that at 7:04, and the one we're interested in is this one here that leaves at 7:58. So now all we do is go down the column, so we can see this train leaves London St Pancras at 7:58. There's no time for Ebbsfleet, that means the train doesn't stop here. There's also no time for Ashford, as again, the train doesn't stop here. This train will then reach Paris at 11:26. So now we know the train leaves at 7:58 and it arrives in Paris at 11:26. So now we've just got to figure out how long this journey takes. So the first thing I'm going to do here is start with this 7:58. So what I'm going to do to make this question easier is see how many minutes I need to add on to take this up to the next hour. Well, we can see from 7:58, we only need to add on 2 minutes to get us to 8 o'clock. And the reason I've done this is because it makes it a lot easier now to figure out the time from 8 o'clock to the time that the train arrives in Paris, which is 11:26. So we can see from 8 o'clock to 11:26, or from 8 o'clock, it takes 3 hours to get to 11 o'clock, and then another 26 minutes needs to be added on to get us to 11:26. So the total journey length is just going to be these two times added together. So 3 hours and 26 minutes. Add on that extra 2 minutes is going to give us a total time of 3 hours and 28 minutes. We won't have to split the times up like we have done here in every single question, but it's a useful tip to keep in mind. Okay, now let's look at part B to the question. What is the difference in time, in hours and minutes, between the time it takes for the 5:43 train and the 7:04 train from London St Pancras to reach Paris? So let's find those trains. So the first one it was talking about was the 5:43 train from London St Pancras, which is here. We can see that calls at Ebbsfleet at 6:03, Ashford at 6:31, and it arrives in Paris at 9:20. The other train it was talking about from London was the 7:04, which is this one here. And this train going down the column calls at Ebbsfleet at 7:25. This particular train then doesn't stop at Ashford, but then it arrives in Paris at 10:26. So now we can figure out the time in hours and minutes that both these journeys take. So for the first train, it leaves at 5:43 and it arrives in Paris at 9:20. So I'm going to split this one up like I did in the last example, because the minutes are smaller. We're going from 43 from London St Pancras to 20 in Paris. So we're starting at 5:43. So all I'm going to do first is take this up to the next hour, which would be 6 o'clock. So to get from 5:43 to 6 o'clock, I would need to add on 17 minutes. So now we can go from 6 o'clock to the time we need, which is 9:20. So from 6 o'clock to 9 o'clock, that would be 3 hours. But then we've got a further 20 minutes that we also need to add on. So all we need to do now is add these two times together. Well, we've got the 17 minutes that we added on first, and then these 3 hours and 20 minutes. So this first train would take 3 hours. And then if we do 17 add 20, that's going to give us 37. So that'd be 3 hours and 37 minutes for this first train. Okay, from the next train, it leaves at 7:04 and it arrives in Paris at 10:26. So because the minutes part is actually bigger in Paris here, we've gone from 4 to 26, we can actually do this in one go. So it leaves at 7:04, it arrives at 10:26. So looking at the hours first, we've gone from 7 to 10. So that means it's gone up by 3 hours. And then looking at the minutes, we go from 4 minutes to 26 minutes. Well, the difference there is 22 minutes. So this second train from London St Pancras to Paris takes 3 hours and 22 minutes. So now to finish the question off, all we need to do is figure out the difference in these times. So the first train took 3 hours and 37 minutes. The second train took 3 hours and 22 minutes. So if we take the hours away, there's going to be no hours left. So looking at the minutes, if we do 37, take away the 22, that's going to leave us with 15 minutes. And that would be our final answer to that one. Okay, so for this question for part A, we've got Jenny needs to get from Welling Corner to Bluewater to start work at 9 a.m. It takes her 15 minutes to walk from her house to the bus stop in Welling Corner. It then takes her 10 minutes to walk from the bus station in Bluewater to her work. What is the latest time Jenny can leave her house to get to work on time? So from the question, we can see that Jenny needs to get a bus from Welling Corner to Bluewater. So to figure this question out, we're actually going to work backwards. We're trying to figure out the latest time that Jenny can leave her house to get to work on time. So we're going to start at her place of work first. We know she needs to be at her place of work in Bluewater at 9 a.m. But we're told in the question, once she arrives at Bluewater, it takes her 10 minutes to walk from that bus station to her place of work. So we can see this last bus here would arrive in Bluewater at 9:03. Well, we can see that's going to be too late already, because then it would take her 10 minutes to walk from the bus station to her place of work, so she would arrive at work at 9:13. So now let's look at the bus before. That bus would arrive at Bluewater at 8:55. So it arrives at the station before 9 a.m. However, we're told that it then takes her 10 minutes to walk from the bus station to her place of work. So if she got this bus, she would actually arrive at work at 9:05. So again, she'd be late. Let's take a look at the bus before. That bus would actually arrive in Bluewater at 8:47. So it'd arrive at the bus station at 8:47. Then a 10-minute walk means she'd arrive at work at 8:57. So we can stop here. We're looking at this column. This is the latest bus she can take to be at work on time. So looking at the column, the bus that arrives at Bluewater at 8:47 would have left Welling Corner at 7:59. So Jenny needs to be at Welling Corner bus stop by 7:59. So because 7:59 is the latest time Jenny can catch a bus from Welling Corner, we now need to figure out what the latest time is that she can leave her house. Well, looking back at the question, we're told it takes her 15 minutes to walk from her house to the bus stop in Welling Corner. So all we're going to do is take these 15 minutes away. So if we do 9 take away 5, that's going to give us 4. 5 take away 1 also gives us 4. And then we've still got our 7 here. So the latest time Jenny can leave her house and still be at work on time is 7:44. Okay, and for part B to this question, we've got using your answer to part A, if Jenny leaves her house at this time, how long would it take her in hours and minutes to get to work? So we've just figured out that Jenny would leave her house at 7:44. And now to figure out her total journey time, we need the time that she would actually arrive at work, which looking back at the question, she gets the 7:59 bus from Welling Corner, which arrives at Bluewater at 8:47, then adding on that 10-minute walk, she arrives at work at 8:57. So now because both the hours and the minutes are bigger in this 8:57 than 7:44, we can just add them on as we go. So in the hours we go from 7 to 8, well that's 1 hour. And then in terms of minutes we go from 44 to 57. So the difference between 44 and 57 is actually 13. So for part B, her total journey time when leaving the house at 7:44 until arriving at work at 8:57 is 1 hour and 13 minutes. And that would be our final answer to this question. So well done if you followed along with those examples. And that's it for this video. If you want to check out any other videos on working with time, then I've left some links on them down in the description, and I've also put a card in the top corner, so feel free to check them out. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any other topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.